It's not just brown genes I'm passing on, it's green genes too. In no particular order, I'm passing on brown genes, two different lines, green genes, leech, croxall, willet, tong, corley, maddox, henshaw, lee, lear, lowndes, burn, jenkinson, millington, stringer, mousedale, overend, perrin, tickle, arden, cheetham, banks, plumley, higginson, thornycroft, dawson, hamnet, smith, two lines, both with an I and a Y, humphreys, scattergood, holdenshaw, mull, abbott, parker, woodwale, baker, two lines of low, bickley, horton, keeling, gent, winstanley, eden, stark, Boardman, Wilkinson, Hesketh, Worthington, Platt, Worley, Hulse, Steele, Rawlinson, Holland, Burton, Warren, Shelton, Aldrut, Davis, Hadfield, Wright, and Leather, and many more direct ancestors I haven't traced yet. I have some lines of ancestry going back more than 10 generations, and there's not the slightest hint of any French Huguenots or Jews, still less any Indians, Africans, or Native Americans. They're English through and through, with a couple of very minor exceptions, which are all from the British Isles. My grandfather's grandfather's grandfather appears to have come from Ireland. This is way back before the potato famine and before detailed passenger records and censuses. I'm guessing he came from Antrim, just on the basis of that's where the surname Macaulay seems most likely to originate from. But even this exception just goes to show just how English I really am. Thomas Macaulay married a local girl, a chapel-goer, not Church of England, which makes me think that Thomas Macaulay was a Protestant. His grandson is listed as a labourer on his marriage records, and he signs the register with his mark and the name Richard Corley. Richard Corley's wife signs her name as Martha Maddox. She is clearly one of the heroines of my family history, because she makes something of her husband. She takes on an illiterate agricultural labourer, and she helps make him a poster boy a Victorian English self-made man. By the time he marries off his daughters, he can sign his own name, and he is the manager of the mill, which is by far the largest employer in the village, and he is the tenant of some very fine property, and the founding treasurer of the MCC. Now, how much more English can you get than to set up your own village cricket club? Forget Marylebone. The proper MCC is based in the village of Moberly, where my mother and her sister were married and many of my ancestors are buried. Bordering onto the village of Moberly is Wilmslow, where the Brown family were based and where my grandparents were married and buried. There we meet the other blessed ancestor, another self-made man, Levi Brown. Born the son of a cotton weaver, who ended his days near destitute as a hawker, Levi began work as a cotton spinner before he was 15, but he went on to become a joiner and builder, who quite literally helped to build the town of Wilmslow into what it has become today. I know who I am, and I can prove it. I know where I come from and where I belong. I know who my ancestors were and what they did and what they are responsible for. And you know what? There are no blacks, Indians, gypsies, or Jews in my ancestry. The last Africans in my family tree left Africa over 20 times further back in prehistory than the time of the mythical Abraham or the pyramid builders. I am not going to buy those myths that the English are a mongrel race, or that we're all descended from immigrants, or that Britain has always been a multiracial society, or that my ancestors were responsible for raping the planet and so we deserve to be wiped out or made to pay reparations in perpetuity. My ancestors were English, all pretty much indistinguishable from my family who are alive today. My children as babies look like my grandparents as babies. Take a look at this group of children, quite a posh looking lot, all very well dressed. All white, all look English because they are all English. One of these faces is a direct ancestor of mine. She carries the genes of two families, both named Brown, one from Wilmslow and one from Moberly. She is the granddaughter of Levi Brown. The faces look like the faces of the children I went to school with. They look like the faces I would have my grandchildren go to school with. The sobering fact is that if my children have children with somebody of a different race, I will share more genes with any of the strangers in this photograph than I would do with my own grandchild. How? Because they are my relatives. They are my eighth and ninth cousins 200 times over. Any of the children from any one of dozens of Cheshire villages will yield the same result. They are not inbred in any negative sense. They have had to marry their distant and sometimes not so distant cousins because that's who was there. There was nobody around who didn't share hundreds and even thousands of ancestors back three or four centuries. Most of humanity throughout history have come from similarly close-knit communities, tribes and nations which keep the genes together. This is how evolution works to make organisms supremely adapted to their environments. We You don't make a species stronger by crossbreeding with the most distantly related organisms that are still interfertile. You select fine examples which have prospered in the same environment. This is sound husbandry, not scary genocidal eugenics. I found the graves of my ancestors next to each other in the same churchyard. Both were yeoman farmers with a similar acreage. They made a fine match. Surely it made sense for the son of a Cheshire yeoman farmer to marry the daughter of a Cheshire yeoman farmer from a nearby farm. They were compatible in genes and lifestyle and expectations. Why would it ever make sense to mix your genes with somebody adapted for a totally different life on another continent? It clearly doesn't make sense. It is not adaptive. It is not to be desired from any reasonable viewpoint. There is, however, one viewpoint under which miscegenation is desirable, the viewpoint of the rootless cosmopolitan. I am as far from being a rootless cosmopolitan as you are likely to find these days. I know where I come from. I know who I am. I am rooted. The rootless cosmopolitans have no home. They don't belong anywhere. They have no loyalty to a people or a country. The rootless cosmopolitans are jealous of our identity and our rootedness. They want to dislodge the rooted and make everybody a bland mongrel mix without an identity or home. That is why they are telling us that we are already mongrels and we don't really belong here in our home. Our lands belong to everybody. There is no value in being pure and we are not pure. This is their big lie. You see it again and again spat out by the rootless cosmopolitans and their dupes. The English are a mongrel race. They have always been black people living here. Immigration is nothing new. Our genes and our culture need enriching. Everything is disgustingly white and it must change. No. My people are white, and they are not disgusting. Our culture is not sick, and it does not need enriching. The message isn't even consistent. How can we be, at the same time, disgustingly white, and yet be a nation of mongrels? We've had loads of black people living here since Roman times. The only consistency in the message is that they want us to stop being a white nation as soon as possible. For whose benefit? Clearly, it isn't for ours. If you want to be foreign, go and live elsewhere. I want to live where my ancestors have lived for centuries, if not millennia. I want my descendants to look like their ancestors. That's reproduction, not replacement. Stop this high-five and fist-bumping nonsense. I'm English. We shake hands. Or if we're really getting on, we pat each other on the back. Get your alien culture out of my face. I am not American, and I'm certainly not black. I don't want to see the children in my country acting like a pack of feral dogs and emulating the speech patterns, gestures, and still less, the lifestyles of black people from Jamaica or America. It's not cool to be foreign or black. And if you think that saying this makes me racist, then you can keep your bigoted, hateful, anti-white racist opinions to yourself. I am not interested in that worthless opinion that despises who I am. I don't want to import a whole load of foreign ways. I know who I am, I know who my people are, and I am not accepting those multicultural myths that our teachers have been paid to stuff us with.